into the tour buses, multi-million. When we was on tour with NSYNC, when we got on stage and we started performing, and the crowd just went crazy. Like, you would have thought we was NSYNC. So I was excited and happy at that point. And I was like, yo, this is you're living your wildest dreams right now.
By the summer of 99, Black was on a hot streak. After completing the tour with NSYNC, Left Eye brought them on the road with TLC.
They love Lisa. They saw Lisa as where they wanted to be. This superstar teaching these young ladies the ropes. That bond became closer and closer.
Those are babies. All she thought about was them. And she spoiled them rotten.
She had a good relationship with Shamari, with Brandy as well. But I know with Natina, it was definitely, you know, a special bond that they shared.
Natina idolized Lisa. They would, like, finish each other's sentences. They both had the same idea of what it meant to live life to the fullest.
While out on the road with TLC, Black's third single was making its way up the charts.
There you are, looking as fine as can be. You fancy car, I can tell you're looking at me. What you wanna do? Are you just gonna sit there and stare, baby, talk to me?
Bring It On To Me was a really catchy song for them. They had everyone singing it.
Oh, baby, bring it on to me, bring it on. But I don't need no fancy cars or diamond rings. Baby, I don't need no.
Oh, baby, bring it on to me.
Bring it on.
Bring me your love, your energy. Slap. Don't get me started.
Would I be too forward if I told you how I feel? That's just the way I do my thing. I'm so real.
It's just timeless, like real harmonies and real like singing and vocal production and vocal arrangement.
Oh, baby, bring it on to me. Bring it on.
That is definitely the song that you play before you're heading out with your little boo thing. They made music that was perfect for that.
Oh, baby, bring it on to me. Baby, bring it on to me.
To this day, it's still on my favorite playlist.
Bring It All to Me reached number 5 on the pop charts. And by 2000, their album had gone platinum.
They had two versions of the record. They had one just featuring them as the group, and then another version featuring Jay-Z, Chazé, which I felt was brilliant.
We started making a little shmoney.
Bring it on, baby.
It was just a good time.
Black seemed to be on top of the world, but behind the scenes, things had begun to come apart. Months prior, 19-year-old Shamari had secretly married and later became pregnant, and now was feeling pressure to end the pregnancy.
Lisa, she was so excited. And she was like, I just want you to know that you can still do this and have your baby. And outside of Lisa, everybody else told me that I couldn't and that I shouldn't.
We were upset about it because she was in the beginning of her career. And we thought that having a baby would interfere with her goals.
I know that she wanted to always be a mom. It was just, what about the group? And I think everybody may have looked at it like that, which I'm sure affected her in a crazy way that we never really discussed, honestly.
I ended up having my abortion because I was influenced by so many different people coming at me. I just listened to everybody else, but I should have listened to Lisa. So that's something that I regret.
Shamari's marriage ended not long after, and by now, the tight-knit relationships within the group had begun to fall apart as well.
There are times when Natina would be with Shamari and they would be picking on Brandy. There would be times when Shamari and Brandy were against Natina, and sometimes it became really big and intense and thick and uncomfortable.
Natina was kind of like, let's just say she was the Tupac of the group, you know, and Brandy would kind of go without saying anything. But you got to watch those quiet people, because when they take in too much, when they snap, it's a fight.
And that prophecy unfortunately came to pass in a hotel room during one of the biggest moments of their career.
So we were,
Judy, bring it on. We are on this huge movie set. Incredible.
I remember we all had separate rooms, and we were on the phone with Johnny, our manager at the time, and we were having a conference call meeting with him. Natina must have said something to me, and I just was like, you know what? This is the last time she gonna say this or whatever she had done to me. So then she goes to Natina's room, and she started banging on Natina's door. She opened that door, and we just started going at it. I mean, like, full-fledged going at it, okay?
I mean, dogs swinging, wigs swinging, everything swinging in the hotel room, and they probably had the biggest brawl of their lifetime.
We got kicked out of the hotel. Almost got kicked out of the damn movie.
I mean, they were sick of each other. They had been on a long tour. The movie added another layer of pressure. That stress at a young age, you're sort of trapped in a dream of your own making.
It was horrible, man. I hate that. We didn't even understand the level that we were on. It took a while for us to get back.
The new $1.99 Sonic.
Despite the issues within the group, by 2000, Black was on top with the platinum record and recognition from Billboard as one of the year's best new artists, hip-hop and R&B. And to top that, the movie they were filming, Bring It On, starring Gabrielle Union and Kirsten Dunst, had hit the big screen.
I thought the movie was super, super corny. I had no idea that it would be a smash number one movie in America for a bunch of weeks at a time. I had it all wrong.
It exposed their brand to more people. That was a great look for them.
Black girls got to win. I think little girls to this day, including my own, get wings from it.
And to pair with a movie, Black recorded a single for the soundtrack titled As If.
As If was another one of those pop crossovers, which was great. The video was amazing. It was funny. It was colorful again. They had the acting bug by then, and the song blew up.
I loved shooting that video. I loved the scene with Natina and the guy. Like, everything she did got him into an accident, or, like, he broke his leg and his eye. I thought it was so cute.
By the close of 2000, Black was riding high off platinum success and a film that went on to gross $90 million worldwide. Up next, Black was set to headline a Nickelodeon tour, but just weeks before it was set to begin, Natina pulled out.
Natina felt like, instead of being on tour, we should be working on our next album.
Like, you're crazy. We're headlining. What are you talking about? No, we're doing this tour. We had already signed off to do the tour. Like, it's happening.
Natina, if she don't feel like it's the best way to go, she's not gonna do it. So me and Brandy, we did a whole entire tour without her. I had to rap Natina's raps, which I don't mind rapping, because I feel like I'm a pretty good rapper. But it was just weird not having Natina's energy on stage.
The fans, where is she? What's going on? We had to keep making up stories every show or every week or every time we did an interview. It just got crazy, if that makes sense.
When the tour ended, Black regrouped and got back in the studio for their sophomore album, this time taking on more creative control and collaborating with a host of different producers, from Dallas Austin to Salaam Remy.
We were executive producers on that album. me and Atina, Brandy, we're all getting along. We're collaborating, really just using that executive side instead of just the creative side.
But as they geared up to release the album, Natina hit them with another surprise. She was expecting a child with her boyfriend, rapper Corrupt.
She's beautiful, you know, it's undeniable. And she just swept me off my feet. Just floating on clouds like, wow. I really loved Natina. When she was pregnant, she didn't really care about music.
By that time, we were going through some major issues. Natina and our manager, Johnny Wright, they clashed a lot. So after we shot the video for our first single, Natina fires Johnny Wright.
I did not want to fire Johnny, okay? I'm putting that on tape. I know what Johnny did for us as a group.
Natina, she goes to Tommy Mottola and says, you got to deal with me now. And Tommy Mottola didn't like that, so we got dropped. The label dropped us.
I mean, devastated. I never, ever thought that that would happen to us. It was just like, wow, a real reality check.
We have Lisa saying that, you know, she's gonna help us do whatever we have to do. That felt good, because I felt like, oh, there's hope. You know, Lisa never let us down.
But that plan never came to pass.
I got a call from Amber. He said, I just got a call that Lisa has been killed in a car accident. I lost it.
I just felt an emptiness. The person that genuinely had the passion for Black, she's gone. Now, Natina was a wreck. They lived together in L.A. like they were together all the time. She was not good. Not good. Nobody was.